Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from GuyNeCube. And I'm currently working on a project that Adam and I are going to use for workshops and videos throughout the year. First stop, Norway. If you haven't registered for Fabric February, go check it out, go register, and we have a workshop there, and you can see more details of this project. But in this project, I'm going out to YouTube to scrape some metrics from our YouTube channel and a couple of other YouTube channels. We're gonna use this data and this process to talk about Fabric, but I need an API key. And when I first start developing out my notebook to extract that data out, I stored that API key in plain text in the notebook, and I got to think, that's not a good idea. I don't want Adam to have my API key, but I don't want the world to have my API key, and I need to store it in a nice, secure place. I did some searching, and I landed on a great learn document that said, hey, you can store this in a key vault, an Azure Key Vault. And I was like, oh, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. So I talk way too much. Enough of all this talking. You know what I like to do? Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing you want to do is go over to Azure and look for Key Vault. Search for Key Vault. Click on Key Vault. You can see all my Key Vaults here. Click create and then fill it out, right? Complete. I just accepted all the defaults. And so it's only going to retain mine for 30 days, but I'm sure you can go and update that property. And so once that's done, you go over to your Key Vault and you need to make note of two things, okay? First, when you go here, you expand objects, you go to secret, you click generate or import. Make sure this is set to manual. Click here, type in what you want to name this particular secret, and then whatever the key is, whatever the secret is that you want to store, you paste it or type it into the text box labeled secret value. You put that right there, and then you can fill out the other items. That didn't matter for me in this case, but you probably want to be a little more thorough. Then you click create. Once you create the secret, make note of the name of it, this right here, and you also need to make note of the vault URI. Once you have that, you can go over to your notebook, and then all you need to do is write one line of code. So I want to store this in a variable. I call it variable API key, and it's MSSparkUtils.credentials.getSecret, the vault URI, and then the name of the secret. And if I run this, or someone that has access to run this, it's going to run this, nothing, right? And so even if I go, let's go here, and I'm going to go API key, and let's go ahead and run this. It's redacted. So even if I gave Adam access to this, that API key is still secure as long as he doesn't have access to my vault. But the value actually is there. Let me show you. Part of the call is for me to make a call out to YouTube to get some information, get everything I need to make these calls out to the API. So I have this channel list, and I want to iterate through this channel list to get certain metrics from each channel. So I'm going to run this. And then what I'm gonna do, you see how I took all this information and put it into the variable YouTube. I need that every time to capture that information. And so I created a function that uses that variable, and now it exposes all those APIs for me, and I can get all these metrics. So if I run this, I'm gonna run this, right? That successfully ran. And I'm gonna execute that function, passing in my list of channel IDs and my YouTube variable. So I'm gonna run that. Just if you think it didn't work, and now I'm just gonna output this, watch this. There's all the information that I need, and I didn't store the key in plain text. Really simple, really easy. Maybe a lot of people use this, but this was very helpful to me. I hope one person out there finds this helpful to them, so you don't have to store your keys directly in plain text. All right, what do you think? You have any questions, comments? You using this method? You run into any challenges with it? Or you have another method that you wanna share with us? Let me know. Post it in the comments below. If you wanna learn more about Fabric and all the workloads in Fabric, there's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.